Ang benepisyo naman para sa colon cancer ay pinagbayor na rin. At bago matapos ang taon, maisasama na rin sa mga benepisyo ng PhilHealth ang chemotherapy para sa cancer sa baga, atay, ovary at prostate. Naglampo tayo ng mas mataas na pondo para sa ating medical assistance program. Kaya higit na mas marami pang mga Pilipino ang matutulungan nito ngayong taon. Aside from our aggressive hiring efforts, we have enhanced medical and allied health programs, allocated seed funds for public medical schools, and launched scholarships and review and upskilling programs. These are to support the medical and nursing professions with a goal to strengthen and increase our human resources for health. As part of our recalibrated health approach towards prevention and healthy habits, we are prioritizing vaccinations, nutrition, mental well-being, and active and healthy lifestyles. Tuloy-tuloy ang ating paghahabol sa pagbabakuna ng mga sanggol at ang mga bata, lalo na sa Region 6 at sa BARM, kung saan kulang pa sa kalahati ang nababakunahan. At tuloy na tuloy din ang Philippine Plan of Action for Nutrition na ating binibigyan tuon ngayong Hulyo, buwan ng nutrition. Ang convergent programs to stamp out hunger and malnutrition were not only successfully launched, but have yielded inspiring results thus far. One survey confirmed that our expanding school-based feeding program has had a significant impact on the physical and mental well-being of more than half of the learner beneficiaries. Therefore, we will continue to further enhance these feeding programs in our schools and daycare centers. The recently launched Walang Gutom 2027 will now be fully rolled out from the initial 2,300 households, now all the way to 300,000 food poor households across the country by the end of this year. But the program will go on until we feed the 1 million most food poor families by 2027. An important component of our strategies to address malnutrition shall be the program for the first 1,000 days or the first 2 years of a child's life. To ensure the health and nutrition of children 0 to 2 years old from the poorest families, we have proposed in the 2025 budget a new grant under the Pantawid Pamilya Pilipino Program for this purpose. Sa pamamagitan nito, ang isang buntis o ang isang ina na benepisyaryo ng 4-piece ay mabibigyan ng karagdagang tulong pinansyal na laan para sa kanya at sa kanyang anak. Ang tulong na ito ay upang matiyak na siya at ang sanggol na kanyang sinapupunan o batang anak ay maaasikaso ng doktor, mababakunahan at mabibigyan ng sapat na nutrisyon. Closely related to this, the DOST has been continuously undertaking scientific research to develop nutritious food and drinks which can be integrated into the government's feeding program. Government is aware of the pressing yet delicate social issues of the day, such as the mental well-being of our people. The DOH has launched its comprehensive mental health plan and ensured sufficient supply of medications. PhilHealth has also released this year its mental health benefit package for all its members. At the same time, grassroots and sports for all programs are back in the mainstream, catering to Filipinos of all ages. Nailunsad na namang muli ang taunang palarong pambansa matapos ang tatlong taon na pagkakatigil nito dahil sa pandemya. Binabati natin ang Marikina at Cebu at ang kagawaran ng edukasyon sa kanilang matagumpay na pagtatanghal ng mga palarong ito. We will continue to support these health-enhancing sports programs. Through these, we will also set forth our youth on the same well-established path that has taken some of our national champions and renowned athletes to sporting greatness. As we speak, 28 of our finest athletes are competing in Paris now for the glory of the Philippines. Let us wish them well and the best of luck. Sa larangan naman ng edukasyon, investing in our own people is not only a fundamental moral imperative for us, but an economic one as well. In its report, the World Bank revealed that our promising economic growth is largely attributable to our people. The great bulk of the country's wealth is being created by the skill, the industry, and the resourcefulness of all Filipinos. Ngunit, sadyang marami pang ibubuga ang Pinoy. We must harness the totality of the Filipinos' potential. Thus, for consecutive years, we have prioritized an increase in budget for the inclusive development of Filipinos, not just in food, nutrition, and health, but even more so in education and training. Recent assessments have revealed the poor reality that more than half of our grades 6, 10, and 12 students have failed to reach the ideal proficiency levels, faring low in information literacy, problem solving, and critical thinking skills. Therefore, our national learning recovery program must proceed without the slightest disruption, especially in basic education. Our system of education must be strategically calibrated to make sure that our youth are not only taught to become literate, but it has also consciously developed them into problem solvers and into critical thinkers, hungry for success, ready for the future. Similarly, as we relentlessly address the classroom gap, the digital gap must also be bridged with equal intensity. We are working towards the day when all students will be equipped with computers, smart TVs, essential programs, digital books, and once again, access to reliable power and the internet. Digitalization and solar-powered electricity must now become the standard features in our schools and in our classrooms. Simply put, this is educational reform through technology. The perennial problem surrounding textbooks shall be resolved. The production of instructional materials, especially textbooks, which are up-to-date and error-free, must be ensured. The whole process, from approval of manuscript to procurement, all the way to distribution, will be cut short from its present 3 years to just 1 year. Ito ngayon ang magiging hamon sa ating bagong kalihim na tiyakin ang pagbangon at pagtaas ng kalidad ng edukasyon sa bansa sa lalong madaling panahon.